So yes, we are going to discuss the letters today. So letters are different from applications because in the application, the scope is a little less. In the application, we can apply for some leave or for exemption, or we want our some complaint to be considered in the application. But in the letter, we can go for details. Okay, we can give our views. So this time we are going to do the letters to the authorities on any issue. So today let's start with the letter to the principal of the school only. So you people can suggest me like which topic would you like to talk to principal? Yes. Okay. Regarding subjective exams, like what do you want? Subjective exams should not be there. Okay, you want to write a letter to the principal regarding exams cancellation. Okay, you again want online exams. Okay, what else? Okay, let me see who talks sensible. Okay, somebody wants mirrors for children's use. Somebody wants online exams again, though this topic has become very obsolete, out of fashion. No one even bothers to listen to this. But even then you are saying this. Yes, what else? Somebody was talking about subjective exams to be conducted or not? Do you want subjective exams to be conducted? Yeah, they are going to be conducted. You want a combination of subjective and objective? Yes. And it will be, it is? Now term one will be subjective plus subjective come objective mix. Then why, what do you want? It's being done as per your choice. Then why will you, now you can write a letter of thank you to principal. Like the authorities have done what you wanted. Yes, what else? Reduction of syllabus. Okay, somebody wants a reduction of syllabus. Let me tell you, like already the syllabus is reduced. Many topics have been, deleted. Otherwise, if you people had been doing all chapters in term one, then you would have realized like what English is. The syllabus is reduced in almost all subjects. What else? Okay, you want to write a letter to the principal regarding subject change. Is that letter or application then?
Application.
Application. Because you want your request to be sanctioned. More subjects. You want more co-curricular activities? Okay, you want some more subjects to be added in your curriculum. But that is something to be done by the CBSE. Their principal can't do anything. Let me tell you what you want actually is. You want some more subjects, some more optional subjects to be introduced, which have already been introduced by CBSE. For example, painting, no? Music. Yeah. Okay, you can talk about this. Okay, leave it. Now let me give you the topic of which would concern you all. Right. Write a letter to the principal of your school. Write a letter to the principal of your school. Requesting her to introduce more vocational subjects, requesting her to introduce more optional subjects in the school for 11th and 12th standard, requesting her to introduce more optional subjects in 11th and 12th standard so that the children are able to so that children are able to choose something from their interest. So that children are able to choose something of their interest. Okay. So in this kind of letter, what would you do? Would you write, what do you think would be the format of this letter? Examination hall. Why? Will we write sender's address here? No. When you write a letter to the editor, then you write sender's letter address. Because that letter is going out. But this letter is within your vicinity where you are. So here you won't write sender's address, only the receiver's address will be there. The principal, name of the school then. So start with the receiver's address. Then it will be followed by
date.
And then it will be followed by subject. Yes. Then salutation. Salutation and then content, of course. And finally, signatory. Complimentary clause, that is yours truly. Yours truly. And then your name. So as far as the format is concerned, only this much. Truly is the most sensible expression you can use everywhere. Sincerely can also be there. Okay, obedience is when you usually say yes. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. But being sincere is better than being obedient. Getting? Being sincere is better than being obedient. Why? I always say, like, there are three expressions which people usually write in the end of the letter or application. Yours faithfully, yours obediently, yours truly. Out of these, yours faithfully is totally obsolete. I don't know why we people have been using it till now. Actually, this expression was introduced by the Britishers for Indians. Because they, you know, like what Britishers used to consider Indians as. Now, let me tell you, dog is a faithful animal. Dog will wag its tail even if its master is a criminal or even if his master is a policeman. For the dog, the master is his master. He is always true to the dog, true to his master. So dog can be faithful, but human being cannot be faithful. Okay, we can question our master. We can question our boss. Okay, so far the things are all right. We can remain sincere and true. But the moment somebody is not okay, then we can question why. So that is like being sincere and true, not faithful. Okay, don't ever write faithful. No, loyal and faithful are again different. Faithful is, I'm told you, dog is a faithful animal. Then you can make out. Faithful person is always yes. And loyal and sincere is same. Okay, when you are sincere, you can still question. Like, why is it so? Right? When the things are not okay, then you can question. And your questioning doesn't mean that you are not loyal. Is that clear? If I give you some order which is unlawful, which is which is not justified, you can ask why. Why, ma'am? Okay? Doesn't mean that you are disloyal to me. Clear? Okay. So this is the format. The question is with you. So you people basically have to think about, like, how to write the content. Okay, when you write the content, in the first paragraph, you can give your self-introduction in brief. Like who you basically are. A student of 11th standard. And facing the problem of, like, right now you are not very happy with the optional subject you've chosen. Because you had only two options, this or that, but and none of them is actually as per your taste or flair or hobby. Painting had always been your passion, or music had always been your passion. Okay, or art and sculpture had always been your passion. Gardening had always been your passion. So these subjects are there in CBSE. And if possible, if our school, you know, is already doing the best in academics, but if yes, here we think like our school can do wonders because we have got a very good music department. We've got a very, very, you know, efficient art and craft department or gardening even or whatever. So you can mention like this is not a big deal for our school because our school is known for it for an excellent, you know, infrastructure and all facilities. So it's only a request and it would be in our favor. Many students would be benefited. So now you start writing. So as far as content is concerned, self-introduction in the very first paragraph, who you are in brief. Come to the point, what exactly you want to say and why. And how will this request benefit the other students also? So finally, expecting a favorable response at the earliest. That's it. Yours truly, XYZ or your name. Okay, now your time starts. You can start writing the letter now. Yes, those who are online students, they also start writing. And after exactly, 5 or 7 minutes, you'll be showing me the value points. Would that be fine?